Humans are naturally able to hear and see only in certain specific frequencies and wavelengths. But space has a multitude of waves beyond our narrow perceptions, so how do we study them? As you may know, sound waves are nothing but air vibrations. When these vibrations are in the range of 20 Hz to 20 kHz, we can hear them. Sound waves basically travel by vibrating the particles in a medium, such as air. These vibrations are passed on to consecutive particles in the medium, meaning that sound waves cannot travel without a medium. The reason we can't hear sound in space is typically due to a lack of such a medium. Fortunately, scientists do have the means to examine certain space waves by converting them into sound waves. Sonification is the conversion of any non-auditory data into sound, and is analogous to data visualization. Space is full of radio waves, plasma waves, magnetic waves, gravitational waves, and shock waves, all of which can travel in space without a medium. These waves are recorded by instruments that can sense them, and the data is then transferred to Earth-based stations, where the waves are sound-coded. NASA has an instrument called EMFISIS, Electric and Magnetic Field Instrument Suite and Integrated Science, plugged into two probe spacecraft that measure magnetic and electric interference as they circle the Earth. There are three electric sensors that measure the electric disturbances and three magnetrons that measure the fluctuations in magnetic fields. Some of the electromagnetic waves lie in the audible frequency range, allowing scientists to translate the remaining recorded frequencies in the audible range to interpret the data. Dozens of space sounds have gone through the sonification process. The human auditory system is unique in the sense that it can identify patterns, so we recognize if a certain tone is repetitive or not. This skill has been used by scientists to segregate and identify data. Robert Alexander, a sonification specialist at the University of Michigan, while studying solar data, heard a hum whose frequency corresponded to the rotation period of the sun. This sound implied that it would probably be periodic. This helped him deduce that there are both fast and slow solar winds that periodically strike the Earth. Sonification has also revealed that Jovian lightning exists. It has helped explore the shock waves that form when a planet's magnetic field hinders a solar wind, and so much more. This practice of sonification has even been used for innovative collaborations between European Southern Observatory fellow Chris Harrison and visually impaired University of Portsmouth astronomer Dr. Nicholas Bonn. Dr. Bonn created a musical wherein he has given touchable forms to stars and black holes. He and his team have reimagined the stars by associating audio volume with a star's brightness, the tone with the star's color, and so on. The sonified data used here could allow access to visually impaired astronomy lovers, proving that sonification has far-reaching effects in the fields of science and beyond. Science has always been multidimensional, and human curiosity has led to some truly amazing discoveries. The study of space by sonification is one such breakthrough that has empowered and enabled us to peer into the depths of space, even though we lack the ability to truly see the entire universe.